listening to National Public Radio News.
This is Morning Edition on WNYC AM and FM New York. 31 degrees under clear skies. Wind chill 23 degrees. Good morning. I'm Mark Hyland. Well, break out your cold weather gear. Mother Nature's offering.
I get up between 4 and 5 most mornings, turn on the coffee pot. I have a very set routine. I have the slippers and everything laid out the night before, roll into them, look out the window, and sit down at my big gray table and sort of start to work. I love that time. I listen to National Public Radio. It's my area of the house, my one area, 4 foot area, where the kids don't touch my markers or my pens. It's a little oasis. And I really love it because I can sort of do the bigger picture thinking as well as the little thinking. And then I wake up the girls, so they have 1 hour to have breakfast, me to make their lunch. Oh, your lunch. Just sort of chat with them a little bit before the day starts, and then I'm off. And the day doesn't stop. The days fly by, and there's no time. Annie, you got to go for the bus. Bye. I'll see you tonight. I take Charlotte down for the carpool, and then I usually just run from there. Our babysitter laughs. She says all the babysitters in the neighborhood know who I am because I'm the wacko always running for the subway at 8 in the morning. My subway ride is 7 minutes long, and I have 7 minutes with no phones, no one there, no one I know. It's a little window into the world. When I come up the steps, my heart starts going, and I get all like, here we go. The inspiration for all the clothes comes from our desire to design clothes for real women like ourselves. A lot of the people at the company are women. We all wear the clothes. We talk about it, how we feel, how our mothers and sisters in the other parts of the country feel. Our whole focus here is on the woman out there and what she might want to look like. I'd say our clothes are, first of all, feminine. They're have an element of classic, chic, modern. They're not frou-frou, frilly. They can be statement clothes, but they don't dominate the woman. I feel like they're comfortable, very friendly. I feel like they're almost can be a means to an end. They allow a woman to look at herself, get dressed, feel good, and then never worry again what she looks like for the rest of the day. There's a big part of me in the clothes we make. I think a lot of women feel that. I know Karen feels that and Gail feels that. That's what we hope is the appeal of the clothes, is that they're easy, accessible, and understandable. I wear the clothes every day.
It's too low. I think this should be raised.
It should be raised.
Let's see it. Can you raise it?
Yeah, too.
Because really, this is line.
But you still can't wear a bra. And maybe that's just too bad for you.
And what's wrong with
what's
that?
What's wrong with that?
Karen and I are a great combination because we have a lot in common and we have a lot that's really different. We have different metabolisms and different styles. I'm much more speedy motor mouth. Karen's more thoughtful.
It's an amazing dynamic. It's what makes the clothes work.
Shortly after we started, I realized that I needed someone who had a strong woven background, and I went out looking and found Karen. She had a gorgeous portfolio. She and I get along. We read the same Victorian novels and the same fiction, so that's sort of a nice sideline for a little break in the day. And we've been together ever since.
Dana and Karen work so well together because they have such a great respect for each other, and they're both very intelligent women to start with, and then they're both very talented, but in two very different ways that complement each other.
Thank you.
This is the best part of it. Past the fittings and the meetings and everything. The drawing, the sitting and playing, pushing the elements around, and, you know, I see a woman in movement. I'd like to capture her in movement. I like the clothes, however structured or tailored they are, to move with her. You'd have to know what that woman wants. You have to make it work for her, not work for a runway. You're addressing reality. I'm addressing reality. I have to know how that woman thinks, feels, where she lives, how she moves, and then I design. A lot of the stuff you see on runways is never really meant to be worn. What I do is really meant to be worn. You're really supposed to put this on in the morning and go through your day and forget about it. Forget about it because you know that you look sleek and professional and polished.
16¾.
Practicality is a factor, but the first factor is that it's beautiful and it makes you look beautiful. When you put this jacket on, you are invested with beauty and your own beauty. I think every woman has a right to her beauty. No matter what the size, no matter what, you know, society at large thinks that she's beautiful or not, every woman should be beautiful.
You know, it's very popular to say now that people are designing for a real woman, and it's something we've been doing forever.
But suppose you had a garment that did that under your jacket, you'd rule the world.
I know each garment like my child, the whole story of them. I think there's a sophistication, and I don't want to say understated, a slight reference to classicism, not trendiness, friendly, inviting.
Clothes have got to be simple, and they've got to move with her, and I like them to have a certain drama. Not too much that it obliterates the woman herself.
We are built on classicism with a twist, with a contemporary flair or a detail.
The key thing here is we're women designing for women.
Drives and makes this company successful is listening to Our Lady. And we never stop.
Hi, I'm Karen. Hi, Karen. How are you?
We still have to get on the road and meet the actual customers to make sure we're staying in touch. People want different things in different parts of the country.
They tell us what women are buying, what they're not buying, why they love something, why they don't love something.
This is great. I travel with this all the time.
I love it when we're out on the road and women say they bought an outfit or a garment and it's been one of the favorite things in their closet. Often when we go on these appearances, women will bring out clothes that they've bought from past seasons and we'll be wearing them as we showed them or mixing in with the new pieces. Doesn't the color
look
colorful? This is going to be a great year. I love it when I get the sense that women treasure the clothes, that they really keep them and have fun wearing them.
So it's the sensibility of seeing forward.
This is my new basic, brown is the new black.
Taking her input and seeing how it would translate forward, how you identify the trends, how you make the colors look different and still be for her.
The sketch is very nice, but this thing has to appear in three dimensions, which means the fabric has to be correct, the fitting, you know, can take 3 or 4 fittings to get this looking exactly right for the real size 8.
For Elizabeth, this really is perfect size 8.
The real size 12.
She really, really knows how things should fit and how they should look and what's wrong with them and how to correct them.
To get it looking perfect on them.
Probably will stay,
being fitted, no. Karen, it's no. Gonna gap.
No, I will move the button down 1/2 inch.
Models are easy to fit. You just make it as tight and sexy as you can and, you know, send them on the runway. But this is the acid test, I think, of any designer, is to make it translated into reality.
I think that's really all there is to it.
I usually try to go up to the sample room and say hello to everybody, see what's going on, feel if there's a buzz up there.
We got so much out this week, I can't believe it.
I know.
It's so exciting.
We have more to do.
We might even have a line.
I walk around a lot. I cover the place several times every day. I like to see all the departments. You can get a great sense of Dana Buchman, this office. And the design rooms, just by walking, you can feel the energy. Plus, I love it.
One of the things that distinguishes our clothes is our attention to detail. Again, because we're women designing for women, we know what it's like to look down at your jacket. And we spend a lot of time, for instance, on our buttons. on the stitching, on the little fine finishes.
Now we're going to release the high hip, and we're going to take in a slider at the bottom hem, so to continue the shape that we want, starting from here all the way down.
They're very, very elegant clothes, very sophisticated, and they fit for a lady.
Savera, do you think we need a scoop in here?
Yes. Well, we're going to come in over here like an eighth of an inch.
I love Savera. In a lot of ways, he's my mentor. He's one of those people that has years of experience. He started training when he was like a kid. There's nothing about a garment that Saverio can't tell you.
Does this look like it's dipping?
Well, now because I'm pulling here, okay. it will be fine when it's all put together again.
Okay. How are you coming? Feeling the pressure?
Everybody's a perfectionist and sort of a maniac.
Your sister's on fire.
And I think that's what's made us successful.
Dana Buchman is the line we designed for women who have careers or who need to be a little more dressed up during their day. It's jacket-based. We usually start with a jacket, whether it's a suit jacket or something a little more relaxed. We do a lot of trousers because a lot of women wear comfortable clothes, but it's very put together.
I would say the underlying femininity of the clothes is something that women can pick out. I don't think we have one detail that we always do. Fashion's not about that. It's got to change. Every season, it's a little different. Dana B and Karen is also thought of as outfits, but it's much more relaxed. It's clothes you wear on the weekend. I know one of the reasons I was so excited to start the line is so I could look a little better for my husband on the weekends.
Viens petite fille dans mon comic strip. Viens faire des bulles, viens faire des
Des clip, crop,
des,
bang,
des,
blanc,
et des
Zish, bam.
Dana and Karen were down working with the designer, Philip, who has been working on really redesigning our aesthetic. He works with Ralph Pucci, and he is the designer who is really recreating what our new look's going to be for the 21st century.
It's rich.
No, absolutely.
It's not cold.
No.
We're very proud of who we are.
Here we're looking at Bloomingdale's right here, actually, right now.
We've become a huge company in 6 years.
You know, we'll reintroduce, you know, a leaf motif.
Now that we're bigger, we feel that it's important to accompany the clothes with an imaging campaign and with all the accoutrement to make it clear to the women of America what the clothes stand for.
I think it's gotten to be theater. I think there's a lot of stuff on runways that are really only there to push the licensed items. And I also think the pace of fashion itself has gotten almost unbearably escalated, this search, this kind of fever for the newest thing, the latest thing. I doubt that women are that obsessed with the very latest thing. I think they want a kind of, timelessness, longevity in their clothes. I think they want stuff that will last.
Clothes are just absolutely fabulous. They're wearable, they look well, not only on the runway, but
and they're easy.
And the street.
That means a lot.
I love looking at fashion shows and fashion as art, fashion as costume and on the runway, but I don't want to do it. These are clothes that people really wear. It's not a fantasy. It's not just runway. It's clothes to wear.
What you'll be seeing is a lot of great sexy looks, which kind of is a lot very sophisticated, what's going on in Dana Buchman.
There's nothing like giving a show. It's so all-consuming.
A lot of great shine and sheen and tweeds, and everything's playing off each other.
We didn't have a day off for like 2 or 3 weeks before the show. The planning was so intense, working every Saturday and Sunday, working late at night. Is this okay? Does this look right? What's the best way to make this? And then there's like all those amazing things that happen at the last minute.
Dana being Karen's vision is a lot about fun, it's casual.
You just go from one thing to the next. And somehow, when you see all the models coming out, they look so effortless and almost languid. And backstage, it's like hysteria. Ah! And then, you know, and out comes another model, and she's so cool. And then when we all come out at the end, it's like, ah, piece of cake, we've been back there, you know, just orderly buttoning jackets and, you know, strapping on shoes, and, you know, it's just been delightful. If anyone ever knew what goes on, it's insane. It's really insane.
There's a warmth to our aesthetic. It's never cold and hard. There's always a curve to our aesthetic because it's feminine. About how a woman feels when she puts on our clothes that makes her feel very feminine. No one else goes at this customer, this lady, in this way. Firmly rooted in femininity. Dana's a great friend. Dana's an extremely hard worker, a very focused, very bright individual. She's fun, she's extremely talented and brilliant.
I don't think of myself as a superwoman at all. I think a lot of American women live these crazy, hectic lives. The life I live now, I've been living this intensely, working this hard since I came to the garment industry 20 years ago. This is me. The main pleasure in my work life is to dress as many women, make as many women look beautiful as I can. I'd love to dress women from head to toe, from the minute they wake up to when they wake up again the next morning. The other main pleasure is my family. And those two things, I would say, with reading a close third, are the three things that drive me. I have a husband and two kids, and when I leave work, I try to leave work for at least a few hours a day and spend with them.